good Josh, General Bakuni, and the entire fraternity of the Sure Shot Academy. I'm grateful for having invited me this afternoon to be with you all. It's a momentous occasion because one batch has terminated your training. You have assimilated, you have digested, and you're all now set to fly with your wings and appear for the examination to join the National Defense Academy. And another batch that has just come in today, and you're all primed, motivated, spirited, with one clear mission in mind, that both the badges together are going to break the perceived record of sending the maximum number of candidates, boys and girls, from the Sure Shot Academy into the National Defense Academy, the Indian Military Academy. So I'm very conscious that you are all fully primed, and I thought it opportune today to speak to you on a couple of important issues. The first of them, I think that you are all blessed. India is one of the historically a very, very pristine and a beautiful country in the world. Our history goes back to 5,000 years. We have done exceptionally well in technology, in trade, in commerce, in human resource development, and entire other faculties of agriculture, industry, town development, urban management, water supplies, all that. So we are proud that we are born as young children, future leaders of modern India, to create that niche and say we are the future leaders of India. We may be from any part of the country. We could be from any community. We could come from any economic strata of society. We could be fair, we could be dark. We could be short, we could be tall. But yet we are all proud that we are together. As a nation, we are strong, and we will surge forward continuously with one application in mind, that we will remain devoted constantly for the emancipation and growth of our nation. So as young leaders, you must all recognize, each one of you sitting here, you could just be one of the finest and greatest leaders of modern India. Who knew Abraham Lincoln, a woodcutter, would become the President of the United States of America? Who knew Abdul Kalam, a newspaper morning vendor boy, would become the Rashtrapati of our country? Kaun janta tha ye? So each one of you, remember, when you touch your heart, there is a pulsating vibration that emanates from there, that you have the potential, you have the capability, you are blessed by some of the finest parents that you have today. You are divine. God has given you everything that you wanted. You went into the best of schools. You graduated from your school, and today you are here in the Sure Shot Academy, an SSB training academy that prepares you for launching into your new career. So long you were floating in a different environment, but now you are going to make history for yourself, and that history will be cardinaled by certain basic principles of life. And the first of them, I think, which this academy, the Sure Shot Academy, tries to imbibe in you, to tell you all that as a persona, as a human being, you are the finest that God has created. There's no one who's better than you, let me tell you. Each one of you. This academy trains you. It modulates you. It creates that infrastructure in your mind, that architecture in your thinking, that you will now, hereinafter, prepare yourself for the finest act of stepping up into your career to becoming great leaders. This academy tells you that of all the services in this nation, one service that determines your value of life, and that is the armed forces, the army, navy, and the air force. Because this service, this profession, is probably, in my own view, the only priceless organization that gives you the greatest of joy as a human being. Because that facet of human joy is bounded not by your wealth, by your property, by your money, by your artifices, but it is formulated by the values that you enshrine. How much of a belief, aspiration, how much of a motivation, how much of a character that you generate within yourself, that is what the armed forces demands of you. So when you step up into your career, you will find a joy is not by the weight of your purse, but it is bounded by the boundaries of your thinking. How much you value character qualities. Now let me share a small story. Long, long time ago, there was a camel owner who went into the market to buy a camel in the deserts, in the Middle East. And there he finds a beautiful camel. He picks up the camel and asks the camel seller, what would be the price? Now, between the camel buyer and the camel seller, there was a huge amount of dialogue that took place, and both thought that they were the best of negotiators. Finally, they struck a bargain, a rate was fixed, and the camel buyer paid that money and he purchased the camel and he took the camel home. When he took the camel home, there he told his servant, remove the saddle of the camel and now we have had a great day today and let's go and rest. So while the servant was removing the saddlery on top of the camel, he found a small bag, a velvet bag. And in that velvet bag, the servant found there were precious jewels kept in that. So he runs to the camel buyer, to the owner, and he says, sir, my lord, there is a velvet bag full of diamond jewels in it. So the owner says, khol ke dikhao mere ko, open it and show it to me. And he sees that diamond and he says, no, I only paid the camel seller the money for the camel and I can't afford to keep this bag full of precious jewels. And he goes back all the way to the market to hand over, return that bag back to the owner. And now the dialogue between the camel buyer and the camel seller is, he says, this is what I found. And the camel seller says, no, I don't even remember that I had kept jewels under my, he says, no, it was there under yours. Then he recalls that the best place, hidden place to keep his jewels was under the saddle of the camel. Now he accepts it and he says, open the jewels. So he opened the jewels and he counted them there. The camel seller found all the jewels were intact. Nothing was missing. But the camel seller says that I have taken two jewels from this bag. My lord, I have taken two jewels from here. So the camel seller says, which jewels have you taken? All of them are here in front of me. He says, no, those priceless jewels are integrity and self-respect. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes,
it says that the integrity that I had in my heart, that I must return what is not mine, is probably the greatest joy of his life. This is what the armed forces will teach you. This is what you will be always motivated to remember upon. So while this story is a very, very intangible, it's a priceless story, because this camel seller could have kept all the jewels and become a rich man, but do you think he would ever go back home and sleep well? He will never get a sleep well. And even on the last day of his life, he will cry. He says, something that was not mine, I have retained here. So remember, ladies and gentlemen, that your character, your unembellished behavior, your discipline. A lot of people ask me in the military, how do you define discipline? I mean, discipline is not merely standing upright, saluting, turning right, turning left, picking a gun, shooting at a target, and then saying, I'm disciplined. That's not discipline. Discipline, in my view, is your conduct and your behavior, your attitude and your thinking when no one is observing you. Remember, when no one is observing you, how do you behave? What do you think? What do you conduct yourself and what do you write? That is your discipline. And the Sure Shot Academy, in this 2 weeks that you are here, will throw up multitude of training probabilities to you. And all that you have to do is pick them up, nuance them into your own system of systems. and then be able to apply it. Now, this examination that you're going through is probably one of the simplest examinations in your life. Don't be scared, don't be traumatized, because this is the simplest examination for simple people who have right values. So don't think that you have to be, who's that gentleman who got 12 gold medals in Usain Bolt in 100 and 200 meters? Do you know his attributes, Usain Bolt? How many of you heard of Usain Bolt? Just raise your hand up, that athlete. Okay, thank you. Usain Bolt got 12 gold medals. He ran only 14 minutes in his life and he participated in two Olympic tournaments. Remember, to get those gold medals and run only 14 minutes in the Olympics, he practiced for 26 years. 26 years of hard work, running only 14 minutes and getting 12 gold medals. Look at the treat that this man had. Did he ever dream about it? He never dreamt about it. So, aap mein kya nahi hai? What is it that you don't have? You have everything in surplus. You have all the attributes and you are one of the finest young men and women of our country. So I will only implore upon each one of you. I will only surge upon you and motivate you to tell you that you are today in the best institution of our country. Here the faculty is outstanding and they will guide you exactly on the lines of what leadership demands upon each one of you. Passing examination, not passing examination is a different subject altogether. But if you are content within your own self and if you are happy that you are becoming a better human being every day, every moment, every class, then you got to tell yourself that I have not gone to learn anything. That is what I keep telling the commandant, that it is not that the students are coming here to learn. It is the students are coming here, each one of you, to interact amongst yourself, to grow amongst yourself. You will learn amongst yourself. And those facets of cumulatively growing and rising like a meteor, a fountainhead on the surface of the earth, is probably the greatest ideal of every student. So I would like you to dream big. I'd appreciate to think that you are now aspiring into the right vocation, into the right job that you're looking at, into the right arena that you're going to jump into, because the armed forces gives you the finest that a human being can ever get. You will travel around the world. You will go around every part of the country. You will meet with all kinds of people. You will be able to think. You will be able to foster a spirit of innovation, creativity, and ability to recall some of the finest instances of your life. Such is the character of our armed forces. Gives you that freedom to become not just a human being, but become a leader of soldiers, airmen and sailors into battle. Where else can you take and lead men into battle? It's only in the armed forces. Where else will that tricolor ever fly on your shoulder? Only on two occasions. When you carry the tricolor into the battle, capture the objective, it's on your shoulder. And finally, when you lay down your life, and you're brought back from there in a coffin, the tricolor wraps you in a wonderful casing to say that here is a great hero of India. That prize you can never get. You can never get in any other profession, because the joy, satisfaction and professional emancipation that you will get is probably unsurpassable by anything. Let me tell you one story. 328 BC, if you recall into history, the Roman Legion, and that is the time when Rome was led by none other than a general called Alexander the Great. Alexander the Great in 326 BC started capturing, he said, I'm going to capture the world. One man on the horse with an army of the Roman Empire captured the entire southern Europe, came into Africa, captured the entire North Africa, went into the Persian Gulf, the Middle East, and captured Afghanistan, and finally came to what today is known as Pakistan and Indian borders. You know, so on the Indus River, on this side, was Alexander the Great, and on the Indian side was Porus, the king of India. Those days was Porus. For 1.5 years, Alexander led forays, 27 forays he launched across the Indus River to capture India. But every time his army was sent back, rolling back by the Indian army there. He could never cross the Indus River. It captured almost half the continent and come. And on one particular evening, at 6 o'clock, four arrows come and hit Alexander, and Alexander falls down. And when he falls down, his blood was flowing out of his body at a rate of almost 100 grams per beat of the heart. So the physician goes and he says, "Me Lord, General Alexander, we must go back now, because the Indian army is not going to allow us to move forward. We want to see you dead in Rome itself." Alexander says, "Get me a paper and pencil, and I want to write a last letter to my mother." And he writes a letter. He says, "Meri pyari ma, my dear mummy, nanna pritiya tai, you gave birth to one son and you called him Alexander. Here opposing me is an army where every soldier of the Indian army is an Alexander. They come like a ton of bricks on me and they have not allowed me to go. What strength, what courage, what dynamism in the army of the Indian army that is." He says, "Yet, my mother, bless me, because I want to fight again another day." And he, you know, they apply bandage and first aid, everything, and he sits up on his horse again, and next day again he launches another attack on Porus again. This time, two arrows come and hit him, and now Alexander falls flat on the ground. And his horse, I don't know how many of you know, the white horse of Alexander was known as Buffalias. If you go between Punch and Rajouri, there's a village called Buffalias, named after the horse of Alexander, because the horse was buried there. Even today, the memorial of Alexander's horse is there, mind you. That's history. We should all be proud of it, that we were the ones who knocked off a huge invading army that had come into our country in 326 BC. And then this time, when Alexander falls down, his doctors go to him and he says, "Alexander, let's rush back immediately." Alexander says, "No." He says, "General, you've got only 2 hours left now for your death." He says, "Give me a last letter," and he writes to the letter, "My dear mother, I am going to die next 2 hours, but when I die and I'm carried in the gun carriage in the Roman Empire with an artillery gun and in a vehicle, my body will be covered in coffin and the Roman Empire will be flying on my coffin. My only desire is that my hand should be outside, and I would like to show my two empty palms to every soldier of the Roman Empire and every man of this world that Alexander the Great carried nothing from this world. All that he did was he gave, and he gave to his army, to his country." That was how Alexander finally died and walked away. Look at the emphasis on the great character qualities of this man, who believes that giving is more important than taking. So when you come into the academy for training here, remember your contribution of sharing your knowledge, your experience, your value system is more important than what you learn from here. You're grown up. Each one of you is grown up. You're an adult citizen of this country today. And therefore, I would like you to grind every effort, churn every capability that you have. Don't let a single second trip your imagination. And don't leave anything unturned, because this is in your grasp. Your career, aapki kismat, aapke mutthi mein hai. And that can only be proved by your hard work. And for that hard work, remember, the danger is social distraction. Please remember, one of the greatest factors of human endeavor in the modern technological era is that you are being spiked away by what I call as social distraction. You're constantly being flocked away from the mainstream, main channel that you're going through television, through social media, through mobile, through internet, through all kinds of misdemeanor. So remember that your character will be determined by how long you stay away from this distraction. Don't let your life be carried away. Let not mobile never tell you, you know, your WhatsApp messages and photographs, left, right and center, distract you. In this 15 days that you're here, you will realize at the end of it all that you have grown in stature, that you have grown in character, that you have grown in imagination, your creativity has come out of you, and you have become a better human being at the end of it all. So think hard, relive your life. Everything is within your grasp. There's nothing that is not within your grasp. It's within yourself. And all that you got to do is taste that great providence that God has enshrined to give to you. God has destined something for you ultimately. Your parents have destined something for you. The faculty here of Sure Shot Academy has destined something for you. If three great divine powers are converging on you, you are nothing else but blessed to achieve the highest results in your life. So I would like to see each one of you in this batch crack that examination and create a window of opportunity to tell your friends, your neighbors, and everyone else in your mohalla, in your street, and in your town, that one place that determines the future of greatness is here. Is here. Because the best minds are here today. The most honest minds are here today. And the thinking power of this institute together will create that capability that will make you great. So I am very confident that India will rise, because you will all rise as great leaders of modern India in whichever field you go in, and on your shoulders will be that tricolor which will shape the future of India's destiny. So remember one thing: when you wear on your shoes, when you tie your laces, remember you are tying the destiny of your nation. Conduct yourself well, behave well, respect others, talk to people well. And these two examples that I gave you of character, of integrity, of self-respect, and the sacrifice to give, I think should be enough to tell you that you are the best. May God give you the power to rise. May you blossom always and every time. May your best always triumph. And I would like to see you all great leaders as time passes by. Thank you very much for allowing me this opportunity to be with you all this evening, ladies and gentlemen. God bless you all, and we hope to see you all as great leaders of modern India. Jai Hind.
Thank you for watching this video. I hope that you found it useful. Don't forget to share it with your friends. Do also leave us a comment down below with suggestions for future videos. If you haven't subscribed to the channel already, make sure that you hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future videos. If this was one of the first videos that you saw from SSB Sure Shot Academy, I would be very happy to inform you that we have two state-of-the-art campuses, one in Bangalore and the other one in Hoshiarpur, Punjab. There is a third branch also coming up in Rudrapur, Uttarakhand. In all these branches, we have state-of-the-art campuses with a full-fledged GTO ground as well. All the instructors at all these branches are elite ex-armed forces officers with years of experience behind them. So every month we have three batches of a 12-day SSB course. Apart from that, we also have weekend courses for people who are working professionals or are students. Apart from that, we also have a 4-day GTO course, and we also organize a PPDT and GTO overview for a very nominal charge. We also have written exam courses for NDA, CDS, FCAT, INET, and the Territorial Army. Apart from these, for the people who cannot make it over to our academy, we also organize online personal interviews, which will be taken by Major General VPS Bhakuni, who is also a former commandant of the SSB Center in Bangalore. We also have an online psych test. If you really want the worth of your money, then I would suggest that you go for the online interview and the psych assessment test combo, which you can avail for a discounted price. So if you're interested to know more about any of these courses or the online interview, make sure that you give us a call on the number which is appearing on your screen. You can also drop us an email at info@ssbsureshot.com. Follow us on Instagram for all the latest updates from our academy. Once again, if you found this video helpful, make sure that you give it a thumbs up and make sure that you subscribe for our future videos. Till then, goodbye and take care.